Hi and welcome to Vocabulary TV. The video lesson you are watching right now is on English vocabulary through mnemonics, wherein we are going to take the help of interesting stories, pictures, example sentences, word definitions, funny phrases, and other word associations to learn some important English words. These are the five words that we will target in this video. I will recommend that you take your own handwritten notes as you go along this lesson. It will help you effectively learn and memorize these words and revise them later. Let's begin. Our first word for today's lesson is impute, and it's a verb. An easy memory clue for this word's definition is hidden in this word itself. Read impute as I am putting. I am putting it on you. If I lay the responsibility or blame of something on you, I am imputing it to you. I am putting it on you. For instance, let's suppose you and I were working on a project and we failed to submit it on time. I may impute our failure to complete the project to your insincerity, saying that you didn't do your part properly. I am putting the blame on you. The verb impute can be used to blame someone for doing something bad, but rarely the word impute can also be used to give credit for good work. Like I may say, I impute the success of this project to your hard work and competence. The nearest synonyms of impute are the words ascribe or attribute. The verb impute means to ascribe, attribute, or charge an act or thought to someone, which is usually in a bad or accusatory sense. Two more examples which will make the meaning of impute crystal clear. Have a look at the following sentence. The boy accidentally broke the vase and imputed the damage to his pet when inquired upon by his father. Then we have this picture of a husband and wife arguing over something. The wife is saying, "It's because of you that the guest left without food." What was that? The wife imputed her husband for the failure of their dinner party, saying he was responsible for it because he had not planned it well. Next word is obstreperous, which is an adjective. This word is derived from the word roots streper, meaning to make a noise, and the prefix of, meaning against. So the word obstreperous literally means to make a noise, to rebel against something, much like a protesting crowd or an unruly child. In fact, I think a protesting crowd, one who are making a lot of noise and are difficult to control, is the best context to learn the meaning of the word obstreperous. So let's make a memory clue around that. Another hint is the word strep, which is very prominent in the word obstreperous. Have you ever had a strep throat, a sore throat? What did you do to cure it? Took strepsils maybe, yeah? So consider the following example sentence. It will help you memorize the meaning of obstreperous. When the singer refused to perform in the concert due to his strep throat, the crowd, which had been waiting for hours, became obstreperous. The meaning of obstreperous is clear from this sentence. The word means noisy and difficult to control. Another image that comes to my mind for this word is that of an obstreperous or unruly kid or even a pet when they are crying and screaming on top of their lungs. And this happens especially when their mom is in the middle of some important work. How do you describe such kids? Obstreperous is the perfect word. This image will help you imagine such a scene. The poor mother was much hassled by her obstreperous kids and the pet dog. Then we have the word dogmatic. It's an adjective. Dogmatic is a very common English word. It is used very frequently. There is an extremely simple and effective mnemonic for dogmatic, and that memory clue is to read the word backwards. What do you read? You get the phrase, I am God, isn't it? A dogmatic person, in simple words, is someone who thinks I am God, and therefore I cannot go wrong on anything. A dogmatic person is one who expresses opinions very strongly or positively as if they were facts. A dogmatic person is very opinionated and will not tolerate anyone questioning or challenging his or her beliefs because he or she is very rigid on those beliefs. For instance, a dogmatic person might insist that women should be covered from head to toe when stepping out in public. Too much insistence on what he or she thinks should be the case ideally, instead of what actually is the case. The word dogmatic is the opposite of the word pragmatic, which we will cover shortly in this lesson. According to Oxford Dictionary, dogmatic means inclined to lay down principles as undeniably true. Here is another example scenario for this word. On your screen, you can see a boss showing an overbearing attitude towards his subordinate, saying, "Dare you challenge me on this?" What can I say? The boss was a dogmatic individual who refused to listen to his subordinates and always imposed himself on them. Saturnine is our next word, which is again an adjective. The word is closely related to Saturn, which is one of the planets of our solar system. And astrologers believe that it is associated with slowness and gloom. The name of the planet itself was derived from the name of the Roman god of agriculture, who was often depicted as a bent old man with a stern, sluggish, meaning slow, and sullen nature. According to a myth, this god, Saturn, fearing that he would be overthrown by one of his children, ate each one of them upon their birth. This is a very famous painting depicting this story. So you can yourself imagine the kind of personality that can be equated to that of Saturn. The adjective Saturnine describes a person who is like Saturn, serious, unfriendly, of a gloomy and sullen disposition. Very often, this adjective is used in phrases such as Saturnine disposition or Saturnine temperament. According to Oxford Dictionary, Saturnine can be used to describe a person or their manner when it is very gloomy and bad-tempered and sulky. An example sentence in this meaning would be, he has a Saturnine disposition, so his classmates never invite him to any of their parties. Sometimes the word Saturnine can also describe someone's facial features or complexion when it is dark or mysterious. Finally, we come to another very common and useful word, pragmatic, which is used as an adjective. There is a one-word synonym of pragmatic and is the best memory clue. That word is practical. Being pragmatic simply means being practical, being realistic. The word pragmatic is commonly used to describe people. A person who is pragmatic is concerned more with matters of fact than with what could be or should be. As an example, look at the picture of this girl who is confused between two travel options. She is unable to decide whether she should travel by air or by train. But we all know that though air travel is faster, it is costly, especially if it's a last-minute decision to book a flight. And if she doesn't want to spend that much money, if she is financially low on resources, she'll take the more pragmatic or practical decision of going by train. So just to sum up, a pragmatic person is one who deals with things sensibly and realistically in a way that is based on practical rather than theoretical considerations. Now, we have reached the second half of this lesson, which targets the usage of these five words through sentences and other notes. We will first test your definitions of the words learned so far by filling the right word in the blanks of the example sentences. You can pause the video for a while to attempt them on your own. And after that, we'll learn the synonyms and antonyms of each word. Forget corporal punishment. Under new rules of teacher's conduct, even tossing and dash kid from class without explanation is no longer an option. And the correct word to go into this blank is obstreperous, which means noisy and difficult to control. Some synonyms of obstreperous are unruly, unmanageable, unrestrained, noisy, vociferous, etc. While antonyms are words such as calm, quiet, and restrained. The teacher dashed the student's failure to his unpreparedness. The word that goes into this blank is imputed. Impute means name the cause of something. Some synonyms of this word are ascribe, assign, attribute, and credit. Good intentions and dash obsessions with eliminating fossil fuels have utterly failed the environmental cause. Yet, activists continue to faithfully cling to them. The word that goes into this blank is dogmatic. Some synonyms of dogmatic are narrow-minded, intolerant, overbearing, arrogant, and opinionated. While antonyms would be words such as low-key, tentative, and open-minded. Locked up in her one-room apartment, she is concerned as to when she will next be able to see her family. But as ever, she takes a dash view. The word that goes into this blank is pragmatic, which means practical. Synonyms are words such as practical, matter-of-fact, sensible, realistic, commonsensical, and rational. While antonyms would be words such as impractical, unrealistic, and idealistic. He wore a dash expression and ate Nutella and peanut butter sandwich, no soiled clothes in sight. And the word that fits into this blank is saturnine. Some synonyms of this word are gloomy, moody, grumpy, melancholic, bad-tempered, and unsmiling. While antonyms would be words such as cheerful and jovial. That brings us to the end of this video. Hope you liked it. Do share it with your friends and colleagues to help us grow and to keep us inspired. Subscribe our channel and stay tuned for more such videos. Thank you.